All right, everyone. So it is April now, and of course we've been waiting for a good day to maiden flight the My First ARF project, and we picked a
today was supposed to be the best day.
An okay
weeks.
Day, but we're gonna do it anyway.
It's 90-degree crosswind. It's gray skies. It's a little bit windy, like 10 miles an hour, but it's the best we've got.
Yeah, it's Illinois.
Yeah,
Illinois in April. So we've already powered this up. Now we have several other content videos on setting up the AS3X, the build video. So if you need any of that info, it's going to be probably in the comment section on Facebook, or if you're watching on YouTube, it'll be below. So Ali, we've set up a buddy box already.
Yep.
What else do we need to do before we go out and fly this?
There's a bunch of pre-flight stuff that's really diligent. It's worthwhile being diligent to do before you fly any plane. Mm-hmm. A foamy, an ARF, a giant scale ARF, whatever. We can run through those. You mentioned buddy box, that's a great thing to do. I mean, some people don't like it, there's a stigma attached, you know, like training wheels and so forth. The fact is, you have control.
Yeah.
The beauty with the buddy box, particularly the wireless buddy box, is I can be stood back and let you have at it. If something goes wrong, if you get into trouble, if you lose sight of it, I release the button and I can take over. Right. So lose the stigma, use a buddy box if you can.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Just to explain, this is the main radio. This right. is what you'll be flying
yep,
on.
That's a Spectrum DX6, as we promised throughout the whole video.
Yep. So I have control of it on this. When we're done with buddy boxing after the first, second, third flight, whatever, I just switch it all over to here.
Yep.
We've used my IX12 as the dummy, as if you like, the slave. That's just literally the four controls. I press this button. You see, I have control here now.
Yep.
Press this button. You have control.
Yep.
Simple as that. Release and so forth. You only have the main flight controls. I'll have all the dual rates and trims and so forth through this radio. So
right.
Don't sweat too much about that. Enjoy the flight. Now, pre-flight range check. I can't go on about how important it is and how worthwhile it is spending 2 or 3 minutes making a range check, particularly on a new receiver and new setup. So we'll just walk through that if you've got time.
Yep.
It's well worth it.
Yep.
There's a range check menu in the radio
okay.
there. Put it into there. You press the I button. That'll reduce power. About 30 meters. So I take about 30 to 40 steps away.
Okay.
I walk 30 to 40 steps away, wiggle the controls, make sure I've got all controls, have somebody hold the airplane, because if something goes wrong, you can
there's
shoot
nothing
off.
To count. You're 30,
exactly.
40 meters
yeah.
away.
Bad
not
idea.
Good. Not good.
And another good point about having somebody hold the airplane, if you want to do a belt and braces range check, you do what I like to do, which is 90 degree segments. You rotate the airplane, you have your friend or your helper rotate the airplane 90. What that does is it puts the receiver system and the antennas under the most amount of load. By that, I mean we have stuff like the battery, or if you've got a gas engine, the ignition, the fuel tank. It gives them the chance to block the signal. I'd rather simulate that on the ground than first flight
yes.
at 300 feet in the air.
Yep.
So if you stand where I'm standing,
okay.
I'll do my 30 meters, 40 paces walk, and I'll when you see me signal like that, just rotate at 90.
Okay.
Telemetry equipped receiver, the visual reference of all the controls working is all you have, and that's usually enough, it's good. But the beauty with using a telemetry equipped receiver like we have in this is that we have real life data showing us the antenna numbers.
Okay.
You've obviously got A and B antennas, 81, 34, well within acceptable limits. The frame rate number 16, this is the critical one, H, hold.
Okay.
Hold is where you have a momentary loss of control. That read zero, that's what you're looking for. If you have even one single H, that's when you need to reassess your receiver position, move the satellite antennas. You must be able to do the range check without one single hold.
Okay.
Whilst it's a reduced power when you press that button, obviously when you go airborne, you're going further away.
Right.
The last thing you want to do is have a hold situation. Now, one more thing on range check before we move on. This is electric equipped, so I did it without the motor turning.
Right.
If you really, really want to be super, super sure, do it with a little bit of motor turning.
Okay.
It simulates the load. But particularly if this was a gas installed airplane or a gas equipped airplane, the gas engines have electronic ignitions.
Right.
They're RF noisy. They could possibly interfere with the radio system. So do your range check with the engine running. So even more important, you have somebody holding onto the plane, and that puts the most stress on the receiver system and so forth. But yeah, range check, AS3X check. We did a bunch of it in the workshop.
Yes.
It's really worthwhile doing one last check before you fly. You can never check enough, because if the gyro's reversed, it can get interesting.
Yeah.
Luckily, you set it up with the off button, so there's that. And a control check, simple, basic control check, which I like to do before every single flight. Behind the airplane, not in front, not beside, behind, so you can't get confused. Left aileron up, right aileron up. Elevator, pull back. Elevator comes up, push forward, dives, left and right. That's a habit you can get into before every flight. It's a great habit, because you just want to make sure everything's going the right way. Bad things happen if those ailerons are working.
And it's a simple thing to catch.
It's happened to me. 37, 38 years of flying, I've probably got ailerons reversed four or five times in those years. So it happens to everyone. You get complacent, you get busy or whatever, and you take off, and it's you can guess how it ends. on that note, AS3X check, turn the AS3X on. I can hear it working. So I simulate a roll to the left. I'm looking for right aileron. It's hard to pick up, but I can see it from here.
Obviously you guys won't be able to see it on camera. But
same with the elevator, clear prop. Simulate a dive, you can see that elevator coming in, and yaw as well. Yaw to the left, and you see right rudder coming in, and vice versa.
Yep.
So, with all of that done, it's time for you to fly your first aft build.
Perfect. Huh? Now, one thing I want to bring up, because this is actually a question we talked about off camera. For my first flight, is there anything I need to be kind of doing, thinking about, should I be, I'll make two mistakes high, should
don't
I be
crash.
Trimming? Well, that's priority one.
Just relax. Yeah. Get your head in the right place. If you're sweating bullets and you're not happy, don't fly.
Yeah.
I understand it's easy for me to say with, years of experience and working in the trade and whatever, but I can't stress it enough. Get your head in the right place, relax, have a, soft drink or just chillax. If the weather's not right, scrap it.
Yeah.
Because you know what? It's better to come back next week than to break the plane and spend 3 weeks repairing it, or even worse.
Yep.
So having said that, today's not great because we've got a dead 90 crosswind. Got to be into wind. Don't try and take this off a crosswind. We've got the runway going this way. We can actually probably take through the grass.
Which is a good thing having those big tires on.
Exactly, yeah. Stakes high is a good thing to get into your head.
Yep.
You don't want to be so high that you can't see it, because at that point you're like, is it left, is it right?
Yep.
But try and have a couple of mistakes beneath you as far as altitude is concerned, and don't overspeed it. So many people take off on full power and they leave it there. Things happen quickly and they generally escalate if things are going wrong. So if you can get it up and flying and then just bring it back, not so it's crawling along, but so it's manageable, so you've got time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sounds good. All right. Well, we're going to go swing down here. We're going to cut this recording and then we're going to take off.
You.
I'm going to take off.
You're doing it rocking up on his nose. Let's get him to graph. Going to the right.
Crashed it. Perfect.
And left aileron.
Left aileron, full left.
So taxiing in this crosswind today, you may want full aileron just to keep it.
Good.
Yep. Here we go. level, hands off, see what it does. So next circuit, when you get it into wind, just to show. What did I say about mistakes high?
I'm not enough.
No. That rudder, use it gently.
Yeah.
That was a big bootful of rudder that caused the plane to snap.
So do we need to turn the travel down, or is that just because I'm just not used to it?
Turn your thumb down.
Turn your thumb down?
Yeah, just a little bit less thumb. And there we have a great example of why we use buddy bumps.
Yes.
So, yeah, what you did was here, you went bootful of rudder.
Yep.
There. See that?
Yep.
That's what happened to you. What I wanted to see was just a little, just gently lean on the rudder.
Okay.
Luckily, you were two mistakes high then.
Right.
Gently with the rudder. Gently. Very powerful.
I'm so used to banging the rudder around this car.
Yeah, it's a car racer in here. Aeroplane. Everything has to be smooth.
Are you ready, Ali?
Yeah. There you go. There you go. Power on. Keep the power on. Then it comes. You don't need to chop the power. Keep the power on. Still short.
Say that.
Ready?
Yeah.
You have control.
Okay.
That's the start plan. Turning in now. You don't need to go so far downwind. Speed right now is equivalent to your flying speed, so you need that power to keep going
right.
Forwards. If you chop your motive force taking you forward and you've got this 30 mile an hour wind blowing you back, guess what happens?
Yeah.
You go backwards.
Yep.
So yeah, good, not bad.
Yep.
It's in one piece.
Luckily.
Yeah.
That was on high rates too.
Yep.
So that's something else I could play with, could put it in low rates and just fly.
Teach your thumb. That's the main thing. You're not racing a car now. This doesn't happen in airplanes.
Yeah.
This is cars and quads and so forth. I get it. It's a different input set.
Yeah.
Even with a low rate rudder on this thing, if you go and jam that rudder over, it will yaw you in. So just get used to smoothing it around. It's more gradual inputs than short, sharp stabs.
Okay.
But you done good for a first flight, for a first half build.
Yeah. Cool.
Good.
Perfect. Well, we'll probably film some more flight footage. We're going to taxi this back in. Or Ali's gonna take off right now.
Couldn't resist.
And we're probably gonna finalize the trimming a little bit as well, just to help with the little bit of diving. So people freaking out.
Flat mode up or not?